Hi, thank you for joining us. I'm Ashley Falls, director of Clio Entertainment, and we're excited to be bringing you another episode of the Creative Mentor series. Now, let me introduce the associate director of Clio Entertainment, Jesse Gerritsen. Hey, Jesse.
Hi Ash, how you doing?
Good, how are you?
Good. I'm excited to be here. I'm really thrilled today. We've got Andrew Irving with us. Andrew's been a creative director for over 20 years, developing marketing campaigns, movie posters, and key art for the biggest entertainment brands. He's currently the chief creative officer and founding partner of Rhubarb, an LA-based entertainment marketing agency. And he's here today to share some wisdom and lessons that he's learned over the years in directing over 100 photo shoots. So I think we're in for a treat. So let's bring him on out. Andrew.
Hi.
Hi,
Hi, Andrew.
how's it going?
I'm doing pretty good. A little nervous.
Don't be nervous. You're going to be great. And we're really excited to hear what you have to say. So take
Okay.
it home.
Well, I was excited about sharing my knowledge after doing so many photo shoots. I thought it'd be great to give some tips and tricks for people, either my peers or young art directors who are coming up. And then when I started thinking about it, I realized that it's not like you can't do a manual for art directing photo shoots. It's each photo shoot is so unique and so different, and it changes depending on the involvement of the client, the mood of the talent, and the style of the photographer. There's so many variables that each time, even after 100 plus photo shoots, it's still brand new every time and very different. So there's no way to really do a manual per se, or to like say like, oh, do X, Y, and Z, and then you'll have a successful photo shoot, because it changes every time. So what I want to do is I want to talk about some photo shoots that left an impression on me, basically by what went wrong at those photo shoots. And usually it was my fault that it went wrong. What does an art director do at a photo shoot? That's the other thing, is that there's no one right way to do it, but what you're supposed to do there is you're supposed to you go in with a concept and you partner with the photographer to get a certain result for the client. And you can do that in many ways. You can be, more quiet, or you can be more vocal. It depends, once again, on the client and the photographer. So anyway, that's what I do. The first photo shoot I want to talk about is the Narcos season one photo shoot. So we came up with this concept where the talent would be in front of a black background, and there would be an explosion of cocaine around them. And the client wisely suggested that we do a test shoot before we go do the actual shoot, which was going to be in Bogota, Colombia. So we rented a studio in Los Angeles, and we had some really talented prop people that came up with this contraption that took, it was like a mechanical arm, and it took like the right amount of cocaine. Well, it wasn't cocaine, it was baking soda, which is a great substitute for cocaine. Not to snort, but to use in a photo shoot. So anyway, it took the right amount of cocaine, and it went like that at the right angle, the right velocity. It hit the body double's back, and then it exploded in the right amounts, and it looked great. It looked fantastic. When we got to the photo shoot, the actual shoot in Bogota, and we were shooting the first actor, Boyd Holbrook, it didn't work at all. It hit Boyd, and then it kind of fizzled. It didn't explode. And then we tried it again and again, and it just didn't work. So we're under the gun, because we have a very strict schedule to stick to. And so we had to figure something out. And what ended up happening is we ditched this wonderful invention, and someone had a red Solo cup full of baking soda and threw it at the talent's back. And it worked great. But that's what we ended up having to do. So I don't know what exactly went wrong, but I think we didn't take into account that Bogota is 8,675 feet above sea level, and the climate is very different than Los Angeles. So I think those things affected the way that baking soda reacts when thrown in the air. The lesson here is not like to be prepared, because we certainly were. We were very prepared. The lesson is that you have to be able to roll with the punches. So you can expect on a photo shoot that something is going to go wrong. Like a lot of things are going to go wrong. They're going to not happen according to plans, because like I said, there's too many variables. So including elevation and climate. The next photo shoot that I wanted to talk about is one that we did for Santa Clarita Diet, starring Drew Barrymore. And it was great working with Drew, and Mark Seliger was the photographer, and he and Drew have been, they go back, he was photographing Drew when she was a really young girl, and they have a great rapport. So it was really great to be part of that, and they read each other's minds, and it was very smooth generally. That's my dog Erwin. So during the shoot, Drew was wearing this outfit that she was a little unsure of. She didn't really like it. So we were reviewing the photos on the monitor, and I wanted to direct her and the client towards some photos that I thought were strong. And in order to direct them towards these photos, I spoke negatively about the ones that I thought were not, you know, not so great. And what I did is I said to Drew, I said, let's face it, you don't look your best here. This isn't the most flattering look. And I thought that was great. I thought it was like nice honesty. But when I said that, the client looked at me like, and the photographer looked at me like, and then Drew looked at me like. So I apparently said something wrong. The client pulled me aside and said like, hey, that's not cool. Women are sometimes insecure about what they're wearing, and you shouldn't criticize what they're wearing. And I then went to Mark Seliger, because he knows Drew so well. And I said, what did I say? What did I do wrong? And he just said this piece of thing that I've carried with me since then. And this is about 4 years ago. And it's just that he said, in order to achieve what you want at a photo shoot, you never need to be negative. You never need to say any negative anything. You can achieve what you want by being positive. So that is true. I've tested it out since then. And Drew came back from changing, and then we had like a little powwow, and she was totally fine, and she was great, and no harm done. But that was a good lesson for me to go forward with. The next photo shoot that I wanted to, before I get into the next photo shoot, is I want to say that invariably, after doing all these shoots, someone comes to you and they tell you like, oh, this person is difficult. She's a bitch. Like there's always some talk about like how difficult the actor is. And 97% of the time, it's absolutely not true. And it didn't take me too long to catch on that when people tell me that, it's just not true. Because it's about the energy of the photographer and the art director that you bring to the photo shoot that sets the tone. Another thing to keep in mind is that they're human too, and they have bad days. They may have worked late the previous night. They may have trouble with their marriage or kids or whatever. Like, you just don't know what's going on. So you can't judge someone based on one meeting with them. So anyway, in this particular case, we were doing a photo shoot for Grace and Frankie, the first season. And I was super excited because I'm a huge fan of Jane Fonda and Lily Tomlin, and also Martin Sheen was there and Sam Waterston. And it was this big all-star cast. And I was excited about it very much. And people started telling me about how difficult Lily Tomlin was. And then they started showing me these videos from these behind the scenes videos from I Heart Huckabees, where she's cursing out the director, David O. Russell. And kind of rightfully so, if you go back and watch these videos. But then she's cursing out like everyone on the set. She's cursing out Dustin Hoffman, fuck you, Dustin Hoffman, fuck you. And she's cursing everyone out, literally. And it's kind of comical. So that did intimidate me a bit. And I was a little nervous now, despite the fact that I know that, like I said, usually it's, you know, it's not true that these actors are difficult. So I just went in very prepared. I analyzed, like, why is she getting so upset at everyone? And the reason she was getting so upset at everyone is because she didn't have clear direction. David O. Russell was changing his mind and didn't give her, like, a clear path and exactly what she was going to do. So in that case, I was made sure to give her exactly what she'd be doing and where this photo shoot would end up. Like, what is the purpose and what does she need to do? So I was prepared to do that. I went in, I was nervous. I explained it to Lily, she understood. She performed like a pro. And after that, I asked her for to take a photo with her. And she's like, a photo? And then she just took her arm and put me in a headlock, grabbed me, and we took a photo. And it was great. So once again, the rumors were not true. The next photo shoot I want to talk about was for The Crown, season one, once again. The Crown season one photo shoot is a really big deal because it was, at the time, it was the most expensive production that Netflix had undertaken. It was like House of Cards and then like The Crown. So a lot of tension on the set, and also it was a very big cast, huge cast, lots of money. The photographer was my friend Jason Bell. He's also an Englishman, and he has photographed the actual royal family, which is one of the reasons that Netflix chose him to shoot this. He's shot the actual Queen Elizabeth. We're doing the shoot. I'm nervous about the shots being in focus because I had a bad experience not too long before this shoot. So I was continually asking Jason Bell, is it in focus? Is it in focus? Is it in focus? So finally he just got exasperated, rightfully so. And he's like, yes, it's in focus. And so I was like, oh, well, why do you have to be such a bitch about it? And then I hear the client, Andrew, can you come here for a second? And so I went over to talk to the client on the side, and she asked me if I could tone down the profanity, that there's seasoned actors here and it's not that kind of set. So I said, I apologized and said, okay, and moved on, went back to where Jason was shooting this actress. And Jason and this actress had a mutual friend in common, and he asked her while shooting, like, oh, do you ever talk to such and such? And then she responded like, no, I don't talk to that cunt. And when she said that, I was like, whoa. And also I'm vindicated. Like I felt like, see, it's fine for me to use profanity. It's totally fine. Like, what is the client talking about? Now, it took me a couple of days to really, for this to sink in, but the lesson here is that no, it was not cool of me to use profanity. The reason being, and I was not vindicated, and it's because the client is paying my check, she's paying the photographer's check, she's paying everyone's salaries. It's her set, it's not my set. So the lesson there is it's not your set. The last shoot I want to talk about is another Narcos photo shoot, Narcos season 2. And this photo shoot also took place in Bogota. And we were shooting the actress Cristina Umana. She's amazing actress, and she played one of the villains in the series. So whenever I go to another country, especially a Spanish-speaking country, I just speak their language because as much as possible, even though my Spanish is terrible, my Turkish and Hindi is worse, but I try. And when we were there in Bogota, I was directing the talent as best I could in Spanish. And in this particular case, Cristina, she didn't speak, her English was not great. So it was actually more appropriate for me to give her direction in Spanish. When she was doing her shoot, she had her mouth open like that a lot. So the client whispered to me, "Hey, can you make sure we get some images with her mouth closed?" So I said, I waited a minute and then I said, "Cristina, cierra la boca." And then she looked at me like, and then people also are looking at me and I'm like, what did I do wrong? And someone whispered to me, he's like, "Oh, you just told her to shut the fuck up." And I was like, "What?" It means close your mouth, but in actuality, like the real translation is like, shut your pie hole. And so Cristina was like taken aback for a minute, but then she started laughing because she realized what I was trying to say. And it turned out that we did another photo shoot with her a couple of years later, and I said hello to her and I said, "Do you remember me?" And she goes, "Yes, you're the one who told me to shut the fuck up." And we had a good laugh. And then so the lesson there, I really didn't do anything wrong. It's not about that. It's about not being afraid to put yourself out there and to look foolish. And if I'm speaking Spanish terribly in a Spanish speaking country, I'm gonna probably look like a fool, but I'm not. But the benefit of that is that people see that you're trying. People see that you're being respectful of their culture and their language, and it goes a long way. And it goes a long way, the effort that you put in there as well. So there's a great quote from Cher: "Until you're ready to look foolish, you'll never have the possibility of being great." And then Steve Jobs said, "Stay hungry, stay foolish." And I'm pretty good at staying foolish.
That was great. Thank you for being so candid and so open with us. It sounds like you've had incredible experiences and there's a lot to learn.
Yeah, I mean, I have more stories, but we only have limited time.
All right, well, maybe we'll have you back for round two. But in the meantime, thanks again for being here, and we'll catch you soon.
Okay, cool. Thank you for the opportunity.
Bye.
Bye.